Hi, I'm Jasmine Greenaway, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can create, update, and delete data with generic forms in Django. So first, we're going to take a look at creating and updating because they're quite similar in terms of code. So here I have my create view, as well as my update view here. So starting on line 23 to 31. And notice that between create view and update view, the model, template name, and fields are the same. So again, using that destination, they're both using destination, using destination form.html, as well as the name and description fields of the destination. So now let's take a look at what this looks like in the form. So as you can see, not too much going on. A few tags here and there. And I use on line 13 form.asp to be able to display that form that allows you to do the update or creation of an item. So now let's take a look at what this looks like in urls.py. So the first one we'll take a look at here is the create view. And this path is destination slash add. Notice that I don't have to include a ID here because remember I'm creating my new destination. So that ID wouldn't be created until after I hit submit on that form and created that new destination. The next one here is update. So notice that I now include the ID because it's an item that's already existing and that we want to update. And here the path is destination ID as well as update here in my URL comp. And again, the template name is destination form. Now, one final thing here is that once you're done making your addition or your update, you're gonna want to tell Django where to go after that process is complete. So here in models.py is where I set where it should go. And what I've set up here is that it should go back to that destination detail page with the updated item or created item. So now let's look at this in the page. Okay, so here I am in an existing destination. And if I want to go and update it, I can just click here on edit destination, and I can put one here just as a test and click save, and it'll take me back to my destination. All right, so let's edit that because the name was good as is, and let's click save here. And now say that I wanted to create a new destination. So I'm actually gonna go back to my list of destinations here, and I'm gonna click add. And we'll just make a test destination here. Test, and then I click save. And now I have my test destination here. Now, what if I wanted to delete it? I could just click this delete destination here, but let's take a look at it first in the code. So first, let's take a look at views.py. And here is my delete view. So notice that it's almost the same as destination update view and create view. So again, using the same model, but the template name is a little different because we want to confirm that whatever you're trying to delete is what you actually want to delete. So we just add a little step there to make sure this is what you want to do. And then for the success URL, if the destination is successfully deleted, we'll go back to our destination views, which is the list of destinations that you can choose. So let's take a look at destination confirm delete. And quite simple, here I just ask, are you sure you want to delete? And the destination name shows up here. And once I click confirm, it'll take me back to that destination list page that we saw earlier. So finally, when I add that delete path, again, I will need the ID of the specific destination that I would like to delete. as well as adding the template name of the confirmation page for deleting the item. So let's go ahead and delete it now. So here we are on the detail page, and now I'm going to click delete destination. And then I confirm that I want to delete. And now we're back at the destination page.